You're allowed to place if and else statements inside other if and else statements. These are called nested statements. You just have to be careful with your curly braces to make sure that you are properly enclosing your blocks. So in this example, we have our outer statements, which would be this one and this one. Pay attention to where the curly braces are. They must be balanced in order to properly enclose their respective bodies. Balanced means that for every open curly brace, there is one corresponding closing curly brace. And then inside each of these outer statements, they each have a nested if-else statement inside. Again, be careful with the curly braces. Make sure they are balanced. And make sure you place them in the correct positions as well. So, for example, if I move this here, then this else clause now has an empty body. And this print statement is now outside of this else clause, which is not what I want. So let me just bring that back here. How does Java evaluate this? When nested if and else statements are involved, you start from the outermost and then move your way inside. So first, we check the outer statements, starting with this one on top. Currently, the value we have for x is not greater than or equal to 0, so this gives us false. Therefore, we immediately execute this corresponding outer else clause. And we go inside its body, where we print this statement out. And then we evaluate this nested if-else statement. We completely ignore these statements above, since this outer block's condition returned false, so we skip it. And then for our nested if-else in this outer else clause, we end up executing the first block, because the condition for it returns true. So if we test this out, our output should say x is negative, followed by x is divisible by 3.